Teachers shape our society in many ways, from when we are small to when we are tall. But what kind of things do we learn when we are small? I found out. Madison Rose is a preschool teacher. With so much knowledge, I was excited to speak with her.
It's very nice to meet you.
Hello.
So you are a teacher?
Yes.
You said it was a preschool, correct?
Yes.
How old are the kids that you work with?
They start at 3 and end at 5.
So what is the average height?
I don't know. I've actually never measured them.
You never measured them?
No.
So you're not worried about how tall they are?
No.
You just accept them for how tall they are?
Yes. I know that they grow.
Do they ever make fun of you for being too tall?
No, they can't talk.
They can't talk?
No.
So what do you do as a teacher if they can't talk?
Sorry. Well, have you heard of the game Airplane?
Heard of the movie Airplane?
Not that, no, not the movie, but like when you put a kid
like
on your feet.
The lady, she just keeps coming out with eggs out of her mouth.
I have never seen that.
I think it's hard-boiled eggs. They just keep taking eggs.
Did people eat them after?
Like, no. Oh. It's just like a, she was just basically just like egg after egg after egg.
No, the game is you, so I take my shoes off because I don't want to put my nasty shoes on these small children.
So you're supposed to walk on them.
No.
So you're stepping on the children.
I am not. I am reverse stepping on them when they're up in the air on my feet and we pretend like they're on an airplane, but then there's turbulence and we crash.
And they enjoy this game?
Yeah. I think.
So what is your favorite subject to teach your kids?
It's either lunch, recess, or social skills.
Those are the three subjects that you teach?
Those are the three main subjects that I teach.
What about shapes?
They know their shapes.
They know their shapes already before they get to you.
They're little geniuses. They're so smart.
So what do you do?
I teach them how to be a little human. Like, you can't steal your friend's food. You can't push other kids. You can't steal toys that other kids are playing with. You gotta wait your turn.
And they don't know that before they come to you.
They do not know that. They also don't know how to talk.
Have you ever heard of the show, Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader?
I have. Hosted by Jeff Foxworthy.
I don't know who that is.
That's the host of
I just know the name of the show. You teaching little children. Do you think that I am smarter than a fifth grader?
You?
With your experience with young children.
Have no experience with fifth graders, but I'm going to assume, depending on the kind of facts, like, if you're thinking, like, history and science and all that stuff, probably not, because these kids have just been, like, filled with this information that they have to know, and you probably don't know any of that information
anymore.
So you're
just saying I'm stupid.
I'm not saying you're stupid. I'm saying you have there's different types of intelligence. I think you have real human intelligence. You're really good at reading people.
Real human intelligence.
Yeah, real human intelligence.
That's important because a lot of people have said that I sound like a robot.
Yeah.
But then obviously I cannot be a robot.
No, you can't.
We don't have artificial intelligence or robots that are adequate enough to display real human intelligence. I'm a real human.
Exactly. That's like enough proof.
It's very important for people to know. People keep saying that, oh, Aaron Dansby is a robot. Aaron Dansby is a robot.
Aaron Dansby is a robot.
But I'm not. I'm not a robot.
Well, I may not necessarily be smarter than a fifth grader. At least now everyone knows I am not a robot. I had a wonderful time speaking with Madison, and I hope you all learned a thing or two about our early development. As always, I'm Aaron, and this has been Ask Aaron.